Hi, I'm Cheryl, and welcome to the Sewing Room Channel. This is the Sewing Tip of the Week, and this tip is all about how to get free patterns, where to get them, how to look for them. So some of the free patterns you can find within your fabric stores. You can even find them on other websites. So when you go into a fabric store, let's say, for instance, Joann Fabrics and Crafts, they have them hanging all over. Some quilt fabric stores, they will have beautiful quilts on display, or maybe a little tote bag or some other little project. And sometimes they offer a free pattern. It's an incentive to buy their fabric and supplies. So I want to show you a few patterns that I have accumulated from Joann Fabrics and Crafts. These are little free patterns hanging all over the store. So let's take a look at some of those. Here is one that I had since 2009. It's a little bit of a turkey applique pattern. It's not a stuffed turkey or anything like that. It just shows you how to design your pieces, how to place them. So it has very, very basic directions. You can also find free patterns on tote bags. Often you'll see this fabric in the store, and it'll give you all the cutting information, all the supplies you need. This is on using this type of closure. They're called frog closures on a pillow. Also, here's a pillow using pom-poms. How to make your pillows using piping on the edges. And then here's a really cute one. I forget how old this is, but this is a coffee cozy and mug rug. Those are adorable. Also, how to use pom-pom fringe on placemats, baby clothing, and a neck scarf. Also, here's one on a poncho. And then this one is on calculating your yardage. That's one question I get asked so much. How much do I need to make a king-size bed quilt? Well, it all depends on how big you want it. So it's up to you. You need to measure and calculate a little bit so you know how much fabric. So little guides like this are helpful. This is home decor fabric guide. And then lining guide for your draperies. And then look at this, a little upholstery project for a small ottoman, draperies, and other curtains. Look at all this, grommet curtains, curtains with pom-poms, and a scissor guide, rotary cutting tool guide, and where do you begin on quilting, the tools that you're going to need, marking pins for your fabric, different trims for home decor, even more here. Here's taking some of their elastic trim and making a headband. This is a fastener's guide for your bags. Here's more trim, how to make little jewel hair ties. And this is using buttons to decorate your projects. Also, a lot of your major chain fabric stores and even some of the quilt fabric store websites have free sewing projects. For instance, at joann.com, you go log into joann.com from the internet, click on Projects and Learning, then Sewing Projects. Now they also have other crafts projects, knits, crochet, all of those things. And in there, everything will be listed. Supplies you need, measurements, all of that. Or Google it. Just say free patterns. They will have that also. You enter free patterns and all kinds of websites come up. Sewing bloggers also list their patterns. Quilt magazines, if you go on their websites, they will also offer free patterns, so they're everywhere. A really good place to find inexpensive patterns is at Walmart, but unfortunately, not all Walmart stores carry fabric and craft items. My local Walmart does, and they also have pattern books that are very inexpensive with the patterns there in drawers. And here's a sample of some that I have purchased recently over the last few months. And this is making a cat and a puppy dog, little plush toys. Here is a fox and an owl. And then this one I just love. It's a teddy bear. And I plan on making this for Christmas. I will have a Christmas tutorial on using Christmas fabric to make this teddy bear. So these patterns were $4.97. Some of their other patterns are even less. They have patterns for clothing, tote bags, home decor, you name it, they got it. In Joann Fabrics and Crafts, you will see usually on a wall that they've got these inexpensive patterns. These are made by large pattern companies that publish patterns in those big books. So their budget patterns are often displayed on a wall. And Simplicity makes them, Butterick and McCall's. And here is one that's called New Look. And I just recently got this. So I've been thinking about making this little jacket here. It's not really a jacket, but it's a little lounging top. It also has pants and a tank top in it. I'm also thinking about making the tank top. If you're interested in either one of these, me doing a video tutorial on it, let me know in the comments section so then I'll know which ones you're mostly interested in. Here is another one I bought a while ago. It is also New Look, and you look at all these things you get on it. Isn't this an adorable pantsuit? Here is two different types of ponchos, and here is all of these different tops with and without a hood. So these are easy stitch and sew, see and sew, so you can see all of the different ones. Here's a New Look pattern, and I made a video on this recently, and it's called Ladies Top Pattern. The link to this is listed below your YouTube screen, so you can still get this. And I made this particular top here, but I put the longer sleeves on it. Here's a dress pattern by See and Sew. And I also have a tutorial on this too, on this one here. So this is really cute. It comes up higher in the front and it has sort of a tail in the back. These are loose fitting, really nice summer dresses. I made this out of a polyester fabric that doesn't stretch, and I made this out of a stretch knit. So both of these I have tutorials on, so look below your YouTube screen. If you want to go out on the internet and go to the New Look and all of those other ones that I showed you, just go on Google, enter the name New Look Patterns. It will take you to the website, and on there you will find even more choices. I also get a lot of requests on the plus size patterns. Many of the pattern companies carry the plus size patterns on their website, so don't feel left out. There's a lot of patterns available to you, and many of them similar to the patterns that I've shown you. I hope you found this sewing tip helpful. I'm always looking for free patterns or budget patterns, and I hear from a lot of you, you're looking for the same thing. If you have a suggestion for a video that maybe some of the other viewers might be interested in, or you have a suggestion for a tip of the week, because I'm always wanting to find things that viewers are interested in learning about. Also, make sure you follow me on Instagram, and don't forget to check out my Facebook page. See you next time, and happy sewing! I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click on the thumbs up button. Don't forget to click on share to share this video with your friends. If you haven't subscribed yet, click on that red subscribe button down there in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Don't forget to click on the bell. I'm Cheryl, and this is a lot of manis. See you next time, and happy sewing!